The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome to another excellent edition of the Power Trading Hour. It doesn't matter whether you're in Jakarta or in Puerto Vallarta. We always love when you come to us at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
So, as we start the day off, we're down about 4 points. Let me update this just to make sure. Yeah, 3-4 points on the S&P cash. Dow's down 20. NASDAQ's down 50. Russell's basically flat. When we get to crude, it's up about 1% at 62.58. Gold's down $2.80. Silver kind of flat. And this is kind of the market that I like for making tops. That is very narrow trading ranges on the commodities, although they will tend to hold up much better. I continue, as I said last week on Friday, after I exited one of my puts, that I'm on the right side of. So I went ahead and got out of it, making a little bit of money. But I think we're probably going to have one more push higher, and that goes into fund buying next week. And I don't know how much there's actually left, but the amount of highs made around the 5th of May are pretty good if you go back into history. Now, things do change, but we have a whole lot of what we've had in the past of May highs, and that is extremely light volume, a market priced for perfection, and earnings not kind of coming in that way. So we'll continue to look, but I'm thinking that we got the Fed tomorrow. We could have some very brief types of spikes across that, maybe a little bit more into fund buying next week. Maybe next Wednesday-ish, and then that's it. And God forbid we get any kind of really bad surprise between then, because volume continues to decay to the upside almost every day, like it does kind of in June. So we're at least a month ahead for declining volume into the summertime or summertime trading. So we shall see. I don't have any burning bush handing me tablets that are engraved or any kind of thing like that. No real big signals here that you can't misinterpret. We've got a whole lot of nothing right now, but that's not uncommon. One of the reasons I got out of my puts and decided to get kind of sideways in the market, or get flat in the market going into the Fed, is just that. The Fed has a huge history of the market going sideways, lighter volume, and not much going on during those days. And of course, really starting to pick up around 2 o'clock tomorrow. This is a little different. We've got a lot of earnings, and we're going to talk about the earnings that came out today and then the earnings we have tonight. But you know what? I don't think we have enough to really move the market tonight. Tomorrow morning, we're going to start picking up. And then, of course, after tomorrow night and Thursday night, I think we're going to have enough of earnings in for everybody to set the tone for the next 3 months and for what's happening. And it's not going to be because a lot of things that people, I think, are saying. It's a lot tougher. But for me, the most expensive market when you talk about stocks that actually have earnings ever. We can't, I guess we got to throw away 2000 as just raw gambling with all the dot-coms that were worthless. But for companies that were actually worth full, eventually, Amazon being $110 and going down to 10 tells you what kind of haircut you can get when far too many people have been gambling in the long term and not thinking that there is ever a time to actually sell. Of course, stock market is very much everybody thinking they're Cinderella and they're all going to leave at 11:59. The answer is that that exit is very small and you don't get to your carriage on time. And I still don't understand why her shoe didn't change back to something else. How did that stay? I don't know. It's one of those stories that I could pick a lot of holes in, but I guess picking holes in fairy tales, probably not the smartest thing to do, as they are just fairy tales. Anyway, give me a call. 877. 877-927-6648. Okay. Okay. That's kind of it. I'm thinking just the way that things have worked in the past, that first week of May, the old saying of sell in May, go away, doesn't work every year. But we've dragged out a higher high with lighter volume really for the last 3 months. And, of course, extremely narrow markets when we look at the put-call ratios. And, of course, when we look at the advanced decline in the form of the summation index, the NASDAQ still looks like you got four stocks driving about 2,500 that are in the NASDAQ. But we shall see. A lot of these stocks off their previous highs. If they all come back kind of in a single wave, you've got a little bit. I don't buy that we're in a lot of rotation here. The percentages in those big four can't take more than one pulling back. So if we get two of them pulling back, the market's going down and it's going down hard. So we can see. Now, some of the things we will be talking about is what we can learn from GLW. They are the makers of the Gorilla Glass Corning. What its earnings look like today, and a few others. But we'll go through earnings real quick, the ones that happened already, give my immediate reaction to those. And then we'll look at earnings later tonight and tomorrow night and into Thursday if we have time. But that's about it. We'll do a little history when we come back, we'll check on the volume right now. And actually, you didn't have much in the way of volume earlier in the day. When we started to head south, I think we were up about 10 points on the S&P cash. When we headed down in red, we did get some more volume. So doing about 6.4 billion shares today compared to about 5.9 billion shares that we had yesterday at this time. So pretty quiet. In the push-up yesterday, a little more volume, but that's pretty much it. Up days are having a little lighter volume, and down days are having a little stronger volume. So it's kind of close, but you'd have to give it to the downside for having a little more volume in the last 2 weeks. We will return just like MacArthur after this break, do some history, and go under.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And we're going to go on and do a little history, then we'll answer some questions fairly quickly.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
On this day in 1805, after marching 500 miles from Egypt, U.S. agent William Eaton leads a small force of U.S. Marines and Berber mercenaries. Wonder if they had anything to do with carpet. Against the Tripolitan port city of Derna, the Marines and Berbers were on a mission to depose Yusuf Karamanlah, the ruling Pasha, which is kind of like a knight ruling governor of a part of a country, of Tripoli, who had seized power from his brother Hamet Pasha, who was sympathetic to the United States. And of course, at that time, from about 1801 to 1805, we had a lot of problem with pirates taking our ships and trying to ransom back their crews to the United States. If you've ever wondered where that last line of "to the shores of Tripoli" comes from, it comes from this. After making sure Yusuf assumed room temperature, we didn't have any real problems for almost another 180 years with piracy on the high seas for U.S. Ships flying the U.S. flag. But on this day, we went to the shores of Tripoli and came off with a good song for the Marines on 1805. Okay, so I wanted to get the question. The first one I have here Let's see. I got others. You can email me at path@tfnn.com, or this would be a good day to give me a call at 877-927-6648. First question is Microvision. I want to say Macrovision because I dealt with those guys for a long time. Those are the guys that made copy protection for VHS tapes. Microvision, a company that really deals with kind of LIDAR, laser range finding, and optical recognition of things like cars, that kind of stuff. I've never been a fan of it. The reason is it's just so incredibly expensive, and you know, if it rains, it's problematic. There's some other issues. They really haven't ever gotten past with LIDAR type stuff. If it's inside, one story. If it's snowing or raining or sleeting, you got a lot of problems with it. Now, most of the other companies are going for the low-priced route or low-expensive route, that is using cameras. They have their own problems, too. But if it's black, laser, or camera, you're always going to have those. As I said, a couple days ago or maybe yesterday, that when I went to the air show a week ago on Saturday, I was looking at one of the new Pipers. And you actually hit a button if your husband who's flying the plane or maybe your wife's flying it. Yeah, but I think a 98% chance it's a guy flying it. If he keels over because he didn't take his blood pressure medicine, there's a big red button in the center of the Piper turbo, and you can just hit that button, and it will fly you to the nearest airport and land pretty much by itself, which is pretty amazing. I haven't seen it actually do it, but guess what? You have a lot of things that are much easier to do on an airstrip without people driving back and forth. You can tell everybody the airport's closed and go away. I've been told that to do that before. Very tough to tell everybody in a crowded highway just to go away because this whatever's going wrong in this particular car. But much easier to do that, and it's just now come along. And there are a lot of technologies that have been tested almost 50 years to do that. GPS, VORs, microwave stuff, GPS, a lot of stuff. I'm just saying this is going to be a lot tougher than anybody ever thought it was going to be. The edge cases are going to be everywhere. Anyway, if you just look at the candle, it pretty much looks exactly what you would look at for a thing called railroad tracks in candlestick charting, a big, big sign of a top. Now, one of the things that happened in this one that where I would have been looking for it is just the massive amount of short positions in this over the last week or so. To me, you had everybody run out yesterday. You had lots of volume. You're coming back today. Now, does this mean that everybody's given up on it? No. But you did have a very good short squeeze. Yes. Yesterday, you ran everybody out, and you're already back in to the trading range fairly quickly. Generally a bad sign. My guess is this is going to consolidate for a while. Now, maybe they've got some kind of contracts I'm unaware of. But this technology is going to take forever to get out the door. As they've said about nuclear fusion, it's the technology of the future and always will be. They've always said the same thing. Eventually, they'll get it done, but it's not easy. And I don't know what else you can say. Pilot becomes decoupled. John Denver, yeah. He has a whole legacy in making sure that fuel valves are not hard to turn and you know which way that they are, because that's what caused him to crash. He had a fuel valve installed in a home-built aircraft, and they had a bunch of people sit in the seat, and they could never turn the fuel valve. He just ran out of gas, but not off that. Okay, question, do you think this mass thing going on is going to change anything? I think it's going to be much harder for anybody to shut down like we did last year. But as I said, the legal fights on that pretty much have said that it's not going to happen. We're not going to go back to the next year. That if we did want to do something, the courts would probably hold that the legislatures would have to vote on it. And, well, someone better get working on spines, because I don't think any of them want to vote on whether to shut down shut down an economy again this year. So don't think we're going to do anything but adapt and overcome over the next year. Well, we're going into the break here. We're going to get into earnings, as I said, here after the break. Give me a call, 877-927-6648. Email me at path at TFNN. And we're going to talk about GLW when we return, as they make, of course, a lot of the glass for smartphones, the Gorilla Glass, which kind of fell under their laps. Then we're going to talk about Apple and, of course, Elon Musk going a mano with Mr. Bezos, calling his bandwidth in question. We'll be back.
Hi, folks, this is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
You could be making money off the stock market. And if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den Trading Room, trading software, and educational webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And where am I at? I want scans. There I am. We've got that one. And we're going to go to GLD right off the bat. Find it. Where's it at? Who knows? It's not GLD. It's GLW, excuse me. And of course, these guys make it first real kind of break below the trend line Doesn't have a lot of volume, but what we do know is that the parts shortage has hit incredibly the low end of phone buying, and just people not making them, parts not available, and that kind of hurt Corning today. Probably doesn't hurt Apple as bad, or Samsung selling expensive phones, but a lot of the phones that would have normally come from China or India or Vietnam assembled in those areas, and of course the cell phones that are made in China, generally sold in China, you know, the part shortages have actually hurt them, and a lot of people in the space are talking about it right now. Take a quick look at Apple, and not much going on in that, but again, they're making high-end stuff. They can afford to pay up for prices, maybe pay off to get products so that they can keep their assembly lines humming, where if you're buying a $99 or $199 smartphone, you may not get it. So at least from what I read between the lines, it is all the stuff that they sell at kind of the lower line. I think they've got 8 versions of Gorilla Glass now. Each time they make it a little better and harder. But I think most of what the lower end Gorilla Glass phones are like, to under $200, $250, are like a Gorilla Glass 3 or 4. They've been around for a while. It's good and it's fairly inexpensive. But people not being able to make those phones, the transition out of a lot of phones and electronics made in China continues to hurt a variety of these manufacturers, and GLW is just one of them. Question in there for is this? I must have this one on the wrong one because I know I just did them tonight. Oh, there it is. Tonight. Question about Microsoft and Google. Microsoft, from what I look at the options, says it's not going to move much of anywhere. Google, bigger and more problematic. I imagine that Microsoft would have to have something that's come out of completely out of left field, and I don't see it. They continue to do well at opening up new markets pretty much every quarter for their cloud systems. I think it's just more of the same. It may be priced for perfection, but they're probably going to hit perfection, but not more than perfection. Now, Google, to me, has a lot more range or possibility for the downside. That is based on just the sheer amount of fines that are coming out of Europe. In fact, Apple is going to get charged tomorrow or on Thursday with criminal action for some of the things it's done. So none of these guys are home free. But Google's got another big line of massive fines coming its way from Europe. So far, it's been kind of giving a speeding ticket to the drivers at the Indianapolis 500. But each time they find them, and Google and Apple and Facebook really act like it's no big deal, they just keep moving it up. So we're talking $5, $10 billion at a whack now. My guess is we're probably going to start seeing $25 and $50 billion until Google and Apple and Facebook and the rest of these guys start paying attention to the laws that they are subject to. But, Google, I think next week has more problems coming along. And everybody says it doesn't matter. And the answer is, just for about everything in the market, it doesn't matter till it matters, and then it's the only thing that matters. I remember people ignoring Microsoft's antitrust suit until the judge dropped the hammer, and it dropped 30% in a day. Eventually, if these guys continue on their ways of ignoring and thumbing their nose at the judges in these cases, somebody's just going to say $50 billion. and maybe they fight it for a while. But my guess is they're going to start getting their attention sooner rather than later on a lot of these issues. And, of course, when we looked at Apple, we talked yesterday about their new operating system that really is going to throw shade on Google, which is another problem, because all of these guys at Google and Facebook have all been pretty much flaunting the user guidelines that Apple has for collecting data. Facebook's up a little bit. That's got to hurt probably by about 10% of what's happening on Facebook. I'm not exactly sure why it really hasn't reacted yet. My guess is it will be problematic. Let's go back to Apple real quick. You're just kind of going sideways out here. Energy's okay. Again, this is a company that bought $28 billion worth of stock over the last year. They've got the cash. I'm not going to be short it, but I am going to say that it's going to be tough to see it go a lot higher when most of the people are probably thinking about selling at least some or more of Apple, as it has its own set of problems. But you know what? If we're talking about movement tonight, I'm thinking Microsoft probably stays within 4% plus or minus. The ones that could move very quickly is Google. Maybe they've got something to say about how much Facebook's changes are going to hurt them. But we got a lot of stuff going on here. AMD, of course, kind of pushing up to this $88 level. $87.15 is the high for today. But things going pretty good. What you dislike is this fairly low level of volume off the $73.86 low from March 8th. There hasn't been a lot of juice as we push back up. And you could make a case with the drop of about 25% of the volume in this last leg that it could get back down to the $72-$73 level. And a lot of that is NVIDIA's problems with making enough video cards. A lot of the machines that AMD goes into need those chips, or people are not willing to upgrade. NVIDIA kind of just on the trend line itself. Like I said, do I see anything that falls apart instantly? Yeah, you could get something out of left field. I just think we've got maybe one more week, maybe to the 5th of May, before all of this turns south. We'll be back after.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at TFNN.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with our 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And we're going to race through the rest of these as we have time here. Amgen, these are all coming earnings. Amgen, just kind of going sideways. Can't give you a lot on that. BXP, which is Boston Properties, right up against resistance on light volume. You had 1.27 million shares the last time. You're up to 108.75 today on about a fourth of that. And maybe a third of that. Yeah, a third of that. CB, which is the Chubb Group. This one actually looks like an ABC on the way down. The volume on this one was horrific from the March 25th low. So if there's one that looks weak already, it is the Chubb Group. CB is the symbol on that one. COF, which is, of course, Capital One, no sign of anything changing here, you know what? Maybe you get a surprise out of it. I don't see much in the way to play it either way, though. Edison International, EIX, back down to the support level going into earnings. That's not any good. Enphase, ENPH, bouncing around its trading range. It's back up to the previous high. Volume's a little light from the March 16th high, but not as bad. Pretty good sector to be in. FireEye, of course, this company took off when everybody found out that he actually did have a good product. We tried to trade it for a number of years, and for whatever reason, they continued to hold their secret sauce underneath a bushel, another biblical reference for the day. And it didn't come out until all the Microsoft server issues came to bat. Kind of just going sideways out here. My guess is this could come back to around $18 on light volume. Maybe they've got a bunch of orders in, finally. But I haven't seen a lot of CEOs willing to throw money at security. And I don't think they're going to until Congress actually forces them to. FTI, which is FMC Technologies, back at fairly decent support, yet a little lighter volume than the February 23rd low, 671. You got to $6.74 on April 21st, and now you're just kind of going sideways. Actually, not a bad-looking chart out here, right where support is. Maybe it needs to consolidate a little bit longer, but not too bad. Google, no signs up here at the top other than a horrific amount of bad news coming its way. In fact, you had congressional hearings on their algorithms, and I didn't see how that came off. But eventually, these guys are going to have to pay the fiddler. Hawaiian Holdings, right at support for a while. Illumina, they've got a presentation also tonight at 5 p.m. So depending on how earnings go and then the presentation, there may be a lot of stuff going on. They're up with about a sixth of the volume of the previous high, But of course, that's going into earnings. So I wouldn't jump on that. Juniper Networks, 10 years ago, it would have been the biggest one of the biggest semis. Now it's just kind of sideways action. Mondelez International hanging at highs over the last couple of weeks, but down fairly weakly, about the third major high on lighter volume for this. So not very good. We already talked about Microsoft a little bit. No side. I'm not expecting it to go too much higher or lower. There didn't, at least the options don't show a lot of volatility in it. Maxim Integrated Products, another one in the semi space. We've go for this one at the highs from 98.44 on January 20th, with 2.9 million shares to 2.3 million shares on February 19th to 1.2 million shares today as you hit it. Generally, when you get to 98, 99 bucks, you're going to hit 100. Question is just whether or not it goes up there a little bit tomorrow and then comes right back into the trading range. Certainly wouldn't do anything tonight, but tomorrow, if it goes higher, could be problematic. Navi, N-A-V-I, Navisate, just straight up. No sign on that either way. To PFG, which is Principal Financial Group. This thing's just been going sideways for 5 days. Pinterest also coming out on the catwalk tonight, doing its little dance on the catwalk. You basically have done a 50% retrace off the high. That's the April 14th high down to the April 21st low. That's 69.85. And if you just do the retracements out here, we'll do this, zoom in on it. Just about a 50% retrace. The energy, though, is very good. So watch for that one on the opportunity that it could actually break out tonight. Starbucks breaking below the medium-term trend line a little bit yesterday and today. Don't know. Haven't been watching coffee bean prices, but maybe something's going on there. Chart looks a little iffy. SKY, Skyline. I think this is Skyline Chili, right? I'm not a chili person. Profile. I can remember living in Cincinnati where all they did was talk about it. Nope, this isn't the same one. Factory-built housing company, a North America company, offers manufacturers and modular homes. Well, as they say, the old double wide. Sells under the brand of Skyline, Champion, Genesis, Athena Park, and Dutch Housing. Excel Homes, Homes of Merit, Redmond Homes, Shore Park, Silvercrest, Titan Homes. Why do they have 400 different names for the same thing? Unknown. Going sideways out here, and of course, I don't know if that tells us anything. If mobile homes are selling a little bit better or a little bit worse. Ternium SA, this is symbol is TX on it, just above the highs. You had a lot of volume into the yesterday, but nothing today going sideways. TXN, Texas Instruments, another one in the semi space as we go, basically another one on 50%. Retest of the move off the April 5th high, 184.28. Again, I'd probably like to see this go and test at least the high of April 16th. That is 194.78. And don't really know much about it other than that. But especially with the shortages and stuff, Texas Instruments doesn't make a lot of super expensive chips. Mildly expensive chips, but I think it's going to tell us a little bit more of how much the shortage is actually affecting the market in the semi space. I wouldn't play it, but I would watch and see what their comments were tonight. When we get back, we've got Visa and Yum C to round out the day.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Markets can rise and fall like the tides. Subscribe to Basil Chapman's newsletter, The Opening Call, and you too can ride the wave. Basil Chapman is an authority in technical analysis. His Chapman Wave trading system has been helping traders identify trends and capitalize on momentum in the markets since 1984. TFNN invites you to test Basil's proprietary Chapman Wave trading methodology with a monthly subscription to the Opening Call newsletter for only $149. Your subscription to the Opening Call comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, as well as daily market updates on key indexes, stocks, and commodities. Ride the wave! Sign up for the Opening Call risk-free today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based, vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge. Just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
S&P flat, Dow up 15, NASDAQ down 39, Russell basically flat. Not looking for much to happen overall until the Fed tomorrow. You've got enough stocks that you could get some a movement early in the morning tomorrow. And then, of course, I suspect we're just going to go flat into the Fed meeting. And then everybody's going to look forward and see what's actually going on after the Fed and those earnings. I think everybody will look at the Fed for about 5 minutes and then they'll go, okay, what's happening now? Of course, with Microsoft being a big one out here tonight, I'm not seeing a lot in it. Now, maybe I'm wrong on that. I don't have a position in it. But tomorrow night, Thursday night, a lot more opportunities for hand grenades to go off. I'll put it that way. So, you know, we got that kind of stuff. We've got fun buying starting pretty much on Monday. We'll be halfway through the week tomorrow. I'm just suspecting, even if the earnings are a little bit disappointing, everybody will figure something else out to chase. But by the end of fund buying next week, that may be the high water mark. Now, maybe we get some giant surprise and the whole market falls apart because it is incredibly weak, especially on the NASDAQ side these days. But we shall see. Anyway, open door technology question about this one. You got a lot of energy off the bottom. You're back up to resistance. I don't know if I can say a lot more about that. You did test the previous low on a significantly lighter volume. But you know what? The real estate market, this has got a fairly decent line off the top and straight down. You're just kind of trying to go through it. You don't have a lot of volume. Still looks like it's in a downtrend to me. Sell when you can, not when you have to. We will turn tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time.